date goes into effect, that it will be $50. That will be for 180 days, correct? And then at the end of that time, they can purchase an additional 30-day permit for $15.
Okay, this one's going to get a little interesting. Why did the council strip the mayor of powers the night he took office?
Okay, now we did not strip the mayor of powers. What we did was bring everything into alignment with calling an emergency situation. That was my understanding of what took place that night.
We also had a couple of problems with a mayor that basically quit after a month. And during his brief period, he made several attempts to manipulate town staff and the council for various reasons. One of the things he did was he shut down the animal shelter because it was called the Quartzsite Animal Shelter. And, you know, we've been recovering from that. We finally got our shelter going back up again. But that's one of the things that we did. The mayor does not need, in this smaller community, he does not need all of that power. You can disagree with me if you want, that's fine, but we have a mayor, or rather a council manager management system, the governing system in 91, just about all cities in the state, and it's advantageous for us. If we operate a lot smoother, we operate a lot better, there's less friction. So that's one of the reasons that we took that step. You know, like I say, it was designed to so that we would be closer in compliance with the rest of the state and the majority of cities. So.
Now that I look back on it, the best thing we ever did, because now we have person that does not even control the meeting. He left it go wild. So it takes the other six council to keep things in line.
Speaking of the mic,
it's very fair what we did. It makes everybody equal on there. Everybody has a vote in it, which is the way it should be. Can't have one person, can't have a dictatorship. That's not what we're about here at all. Everybody elected, we're all elected, the mayor, every one of us. But it doesn't put one person in control of every little thing. So that's where I kind of feel that we did the right thing.
Next question. Why did the town not notify business owners of water system flush today? How can this work better? I hope somebody understands it, because I don't. Why did the town not notify business owners of water system flush today?
Usually we do, and I'm not aware that we did that today. Whoever gave us that note, if they would come and talk to administration, to myself, or to one of the department heads here, then we can check it out. But customarily, we don't do it.
Okay, whoever submitted that, if you'll check with one of these people at break time or at the end of the meeting. Let them know, and they can get back to you. Did everybody know we had coffee and cookies over here? Coffee and cookies? Anybody need a coffee? I have a message for the person that submitted this one. It's really nice you typed it. I can read it. Put it in bigger font, will you, next time? My old eyes. I just got new prescriptions, and they're wonderful. Okay? I can see out of my left eye, not my right eye. just got brand new prescription. My eyes changed. I'm having a real problem with my eyes in the last few years. They change almost overnight. Hope none of you get that same problem. All right, there's seven questions here. Why has the water and sewer rates more than doubled? I think we've already addressed that. Anybody else want to comment on that? Okay. Why is the town water brown and or smell? I could give an answer, but I suppose I shouldn't.
It would be good not to in this case. I can tell by your expression. Iron is what causes some of the color issues in sulfur. We do have a higher level of iron and manganese in our water. We've looked into it with ADQ. Our water operator, Mr. Cruz, has checked into it. We can get a filter for this. They cost $1 million per well site, which is obviously why we haven't done that. The smell is coming from sulfur.
Just to refresh everybody, how many well sites do we have? Two. So if anybody's got an extra 2 million laying around, we can get a filter.
Skip, may I
add
something? Okay, it doesn't cover the water situation in Quartzsite. This last summer, my husband and I went to Kenai, Alaska to visit our son and daughter-in-law. The water up there is yellow, and it does have kind of a funky odor. It's yellow because of all the vegetation in the ground. So if we have to take into account what part of the country you live in as to how it's going to affect the water.
Just a little sidebar. I grew up in western South Dakota, the western half, and I always thought water was just water, you know, and you could drink water anywhere in the western half, and it was great water. Then my oldest sister got married to a farmer over east of the river. Anybody from Dakota, you know what I mean by that comment. Anyway, I went over to spend the summer. They were on artesian well. You think Quartzsite has bad water? Please go to here in South Dakota, and I dare you to drink a glass of water. And they do it every day in their life. I can't get near a glass of artesian water. This water is almost crystal clear by comparison. Okay. Why is it impossible to close down an illegal business or pull a vendor permit?
As far as an illegal business, I'm not quite sure what you're referring to, but I would say that the requirements here in the town of Quartzsite are that you are required to have a business license that is valid during the time that you are open for business. Now, in the past, we have been reluctant to pull a business license because it is a costly affair, and that's why we have modified Chapter 8 so that basically what our administrative code has always said is that if you are going to have a business license or if you are going to do business in the town of Quartzsite, you are required to comply with the town of Quartzsite's administrative code, the laws of La Paz County, the state of Arizona, etc. So it's always been in the administrative code that you are supposed to be following the rules of the town, the county, and the state. It can be a very expensive proposition to deal with this because generally it winds up in court and can be a very long and arduous task.
What's the second part?
Why is it also possible to close an illegal business or pull a vendor permit?
Now, when you're asking about pulling a vendor permit, do you mean to pull it away from the vendor, or do you mean to come in, apply, and you feel that it's impossible to pull a permit at town hall?
I would guess it's after they've got the permit to pull it at that point.
Okay. Again, the town's administrative code was ambiguous, and we have had, I asked a consultant to help us rewrite the revocability section of Chapter 8, and that went down to the town attorney. That's been revised, and if the new resolution is passed, under Chapter 8.3, we will have the ability to revoke business licenses or vendor permits based on what I said earlier, not complying with state or federal laws. If you're convicted of a crime, if you're doing drugs or something that is, you know, contrary to law. And keep in mind that when you are a vendor and you are renting space from somebody, the landlord has the ability to ask you to leave at any time. So if they ask you to leave, then you would be required to come back down to town hall. You would change address, and at that point we can look at the situation as to why you were asked to leave, and we would review it. But just like anything else, people have rights, and we try to be fair. We don't try to jump to conclusions.
Why should anyone pay for a permit when it seems there is no enforcement?
Okay, are we talking business permits, vendor permits, or building?